Welcome back to the Midday Show. April is Oral Health Month, and in that vein, we've got Dr. Preeti Desai joining us on the set. She is a laser implant specialist. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, Cheryl.
You brought so much cool stuff with you. So I think
I'm
we just need
to find it cool.
Yeah, we need to dive right into it. You call it the gadgets.
There are a lot of gadgets in the pharmacy. When you walk in, I think people will feel overwhelmed if they're looking for an electric toothbrush. Mm-hmm. And I get that question all the time in my office. So I thought I'd bring in a little bit of a demo of what is, you know, a sample of what's available, mm-hmm. and to help people ask the right questions of what to look for in a gadget.
Because I guess it depends on your needs as well, what you're looking for, right?
Absolutely. I mean, if you need some help just getting into a routine of brushing your teeth, any gadget will help. If you have a small mouth, you don't want a brush with big bristles. Mm-hmm. If you are a little bit sensitive, you don't want something with high frequency. Right. So there's a lot of, you know, pros and cons to each detail.
Right. Okay, so let's talk about some of the ones that you brought in then.
Yeah, so I mean, these are some of the bigger companies that are out there, the Oral-B, the Philips, the Sonicare. And you can see, even if an electric toothbrush of the same company can have different head sizes. Mm-hmm. So if you don't like something big in your mouth, this would be your choice. Mm-hmm. If you don't like bristles that are long, this would be more of a rotating brush. Mm-hmm. So they all move in different ways as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now, will your pharmacist be able to help you as well if you give him sort of the guidelines of what you're looking for?
Yeah, some pharmacists are very, very knowledgeable on mm-hmm. it. A lot of them in town would help, yeah.
Okay, and do we need one? That's the next question. Like, how important is it to my oral health to have one of those toothbrushes?
The most important thing for your oral health is that you brush every day.
Right.
It doesn't matter what you use. Mm-hmm. And the most important thing, though, is to have something with a soft bristle head. Mm-hmm. Because it's the brush is used against gums as well as teeth. Mm-hmm. So the gums are softer than teeth, tooth surface, and so you can't scrub away. And so if you use something manual or electric, it's how you use the brush. That's the most important.
Right, so the old days of, because I remember growing up, it's like you have to brush really hard and
Absolutely.
Get right in there and everything, and you don't do that anymore.
No, that technique is out, and here I'll just show a quick demonstration of even if you use an electric toothbrush.
Very pretty teeth.
Or these are perfect teeth.
Perfect.
Just finish with treatment. Is to kind of use it in a, okay, if I'm the patient, to kind of use it in a sweeping action, mm-hmm. even if it's on or off, you can not turn it on all the time and go the way the teeth grow. Mm-hmm. That's the secret of brushing nice and soft. Mm-hmm. And that way you get all the debris on the side of the tooth and you don't damage the gums.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So going like this is probably not a good idea, doing the whole scrubbing.
We're not cleaning the bathtub.
Doing this, no good. Okay.
No good. And the other thing is, of course, the tooth is 360 degrees. Mm-hmm. And we want to, of course, get in between the teeth with floss, mm-hmm. right? And there's different gadgets on the market with cleaning in between the teeth. Mm-hmm. Some I think are almost like weapons. This is a
it looks very high tech, like we should be beaming up somewhere.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome, but if you push it, a blast of like air would come out of it.
Oh.
And it's actually pretty powerful.
Yeah.
And
definitely.
So I'm not a big fan of that simply because I think you can actually do more damage than good to it. Mm-hmm. And there's also even an app, of course, now available.
Of course. Now how is that gonna help me clean my teeth?
Mainly,
explain that to me.
This is the app that's available. It's called the Beam Toothbrush, mm-hmm. and you can actually, you know, have a timer on it, and
that's awesome.
It syncs with your phone, with your toothbrush, so it just kind of keeps you motivated to take care of your teeth. That's the bottom line.
Mm-hmm. So yeah. We know brushing is very important, but you've got some other things here that are sort of part of the whole package, I would think.
Yeah, so there's a lot of products on the market for rinsing as mm-hmm. well. And there's actually a recent study coming out of Glasgow that showed that the alcohol in rinses can cause a higher risk of oral cancer. So you must choose a rinse that has no alcohol in it.
Okay.
On top of which, it's quite burning to the gums and tissue. So you mm-hmm. can see here a lot of the products say no alcohol, so that's really vital. Mm-hmm. As far as how effective it is, it doesn't really do anything but make your breath smell fresh. Mm-hmm. And that's good, that's beneficial, but it's mm-hmm. not gonna help your oral hygiene. There are whitening strips on the market, which a lot of people ask about. Mm-hmm. But it's really important to also talk to your dentist about whitening. I don't do whitening because I'm a specialist, but There's a lot of damage that can be done with whitening over the counter too, so you have to talk to your dentist about that.
Okay, so obviously lots involved with your teeth, so the best thing to do probably is to ask your dentist or a specialist like Dr. Preeti Desai. Thank you so much for joining us today.
My pleasure.
We'll be back in just a moment here on Midday.